Jaipur, the glorious pink city of India, sets many a hearts aflutter with visions of grandeur, valor, romance and beauty. This heritage city's inherent historic charm has always been a major source of attraction. Travelers, poets and philosophers have lavished praises on it. Perhaps no other place is imbued with the richness of ritual and ceremony across the country as Jaipur is. The city was founded on 18th November 1727 by Kachwaha ruler Maharaja Sawai Jai Singh II. Its plans were based on Shilp Shastra and Vastu Shastra with meticulous planning, aesthetics and functional use. In fact, Jaipur is also well known as the first planned city of India. That is why it is said that, what have you achieved in this world if you haven't seen Jaipur? The history of the Mughals, Marathas, the British Empire is incomplete without acknowledging the contribution of the Kachwaha dynasty of Jaipur, which was laid by Dule Rai in 1966 AD with Dausa as its first capital. Later, Khoh and Amer was the third capital of the Kachwahas and it continued to remain so for a period of almost seven centuries. Raja Man Singh I of Amer was the most powerful and celebrated prince of Amer and one of the most famous generals of Mughal Emperor Akbar. These rulers of Amer and Jaipur have played pivotal role in enriching its arts, crafts, culture, literature and architecture while preserving its essential characters. Each new ruler or regime, every phase of history and every brick on every facade of a fort or a palace added immensely to the city's treasure trove of traditions, shaping its heritage, rich and vibrantly hued as the jewels of royalty. The breathtaking view of the South and North Block in Delhi and the Taj Mahal in Agra are one of the notable contributions of the Kachwaha dynasty. The ancient plan and architecture of Jaipur gives an in-depth idea of how Maharaja Sawai Jai Singh II, founder of Jaipur, respected all religions. For his unique contribution to mathematics and astronomy, he has been called the Pope Gregory of India. He frequently invited intellectuals, scientists, teachers, writers, poets, painters, architects and lawmakers to his court. Great achievements were also made by the Maharaja in the field of diplomacy, statecraft and architecture. He was ably supported by an efficient team of ministers and confidantes. Vidyadhar Chakravarti of Bengal was the favorite minister of Maharaja. The original plan was devised by him before laying the foundation of the city of Jaipur. The city was planned in a symmetrical, linear design with wide arterial roads and commercial zones. Plans were solicited from all over India and abroad and were prepared on sheet of cloth which contained the layout with perspective views of individual buildings and palaces prior to the construction. The printed map of Jaipur, depicting the city as it looked in the 18th century, clearly shows the fortifications extending right up to the hills. The city took shape under the Kachwaha rulers. Primary characteristics of town include its perfect combination of commerce and beauty. A great deal of planning has gone into each and every aspect of the city, including its shops. It provides glimpse into the daily hustle and bustle of a busy marketplace during the day. railway station and bazaars were also built. The travelers were much impressed with the planning of the bazaars. Provision was even made for the entertainment of people. Jaipur has been a city where all faiths and religions have coexisted peacefully. Maharajas believed that all citizens should be free to practice, profess, and propagate their own faith. These traditions are still very much alive and throbbing in every nook and corner of Pink City. Jaipur was once by dense jungle. The rulers earmarked sanctuaries and game areas where the diversity of both plants and wildlife could be protected. Each thikana had a budget for its conservation. The legacy of the Maharajas who built gardens, ponds and water bodies in and around Jaipur and took special pains to conserve nature in its pristine glory has given the people an opportunity to both enjoy their land and appreciate the need for protecting it. Right from ancient times, the denizens of Jaipur have nurtured and worshipped the different life forms and vegetation. Planting at least one such tree in one's lifetime was considered both a social and divine duty, for each Hindu, and cutting trees was prohibited. Cheetahs were used as a hunting tool for entertainment of Maharajas. Wajid Khan was appointed in the Shikar Khana of Sawai Jagat Singh and entrusted with the task of breeding and training cheetahs in captivity for deer hunts in Cheeton Ki Mori. Even Akbar and later Jahangir and their queen's favorite sport was to hunt in the jungles of Jaipur. Maharajas also enjoyed falconry, the art of training falcons for hunting, which most probably came to Amer during the rule of Raja Man Singh I. It was not just a hobby, but a lifestyle which required investment of time with immense patience. Polo was another popular sport which flourished in Jaipur since the days of Sawai Man Singh II, who not only patronized the sport, but was recognized as a player of international class. In 1930, the All India Polo Championship was won by Jaipur. People of Jaipur have always been a happy-go-lucky lot, enjoying every facet of their simple lives and living life to the fullest despite adversities. During the festive seasons, singers and dancers rejoice in full masti. This swirl by Kalbelia dancers gives a feel of the rich traditional heritage of the region. Their sinuous movements and rapid twirls have to be seen to be believed and can make anyone dizzy with their agility and swiftness. And these are the chung players dancing on the musical beats. As it is said, there are 9 festivals on the 7 days of a week. This adage sits very aptly for Jaipur, which is easily a land of festivals. There is a festival for each and every season, symbolic of the zest for life and exuberance and vivacity of the people living here. Jaipurites take great pride in their traditions, history and religions, and accordingly, there is a never-ending cycle of festivals and fairs throughout the year. The successful transition of Jaipur towards modernity had begun right from late 1800 itself. All prominent Maharajas left behind a city that was economically prosperous and visually appealing, thus earning tributes such as Paris-like in beauty, Budapest-like in bewitchment, and Moscow-like in grandeur. Sawai Man Singh II was born as Kanwar Mor Mukut Singh and chosen for adoption by Maharaja Sawai Madho Singh II. He was renamed Sawai Man Singh II and became popular for for his public welfare schemes and philanthropy. Besides, he introduced several new and innovative policies in the interest of public. He was married to Maharani Marudhar Kanwar, Maharani Kishore Kanwar, and Maharani Gayatri Devi. They all played significant roles in his life. Along with Sawai Man Singh II, the name that is most associated with Jaipur royalty is that of Maharani Gayatri Devi, who was recognized as one of the style icons of the country. She was extremely beautiful and listed by Vogue as one of the world's 10 most beautiful women. Mahavir Chakra awardee Maharaja Sawai Bhavani Singh was the eldest son of Sawai Man Singh II. Birthday celebration of Maharaja Sawai Bhavani Singh always used to be a grand celebration where family friends would gather to pay respects. Celebrations would continue in the Zanana where his wife Maharani Padmini Devi and daughter Princess Diya Kumari would also enjoy in the revelry. Here, the three generations of the contemporary royal family of Jaipur in regal black attire. The coronation of Maharaja Sawai Padmanabh Singh, who was adopted by late Maharaja Sawai Bhavani Singh as his crown prince and enthroned on Jaipur Rajgaddi, was held in 2011. Yet another attraction of Jaipur is its architectural wonders, which deserves a special mention. The famed traveler Max Lerner called Jaipur one of the three most beautiful cities of the world. The City Palace complex stands at the core of the city within a walled enclosure. It was originally built by Maharaja Sawai Jai Singh II and was subsequently enlarged and enriched by his successors. It is one of the most extensive palaces of a Hindu ruler of the Mughal era. It has been used for religious rituals, entertainment, political administration, and various ceremonies of the court. Shobha Nivas or the Hall of Beauty occupies the fourth floor of the elegant Chandra Mahal and exudes extraordinary beauty because of its mirror, gold leaf, and mica work. Jantar Mantar is an open-air observatory that lies outside the gateway of the City Palace complex, which has been included in UNESCO's list of World Heritage Site. The famous Hawa Mahal, or the Palace of Winds, is the most prominent landmark of Jaipur, which was built in 1799 by Sawai Pratap Singh, the poet king. During his reign, he would spend a lot of time here, composing dohas, couplets, and songs. The structure has five stories, which resemble the crown of Lord Krishna. The Albert Hall Museum in the Ram Nivas Bagh, surrounded by a beautiful garden, derives its name from King Albert Edward, designed by Colonel Jacob. It is one of the oldest museums of Rajasthan, which has a rich collection of artifacts. The Isar Lat the Tower with seven octagonal stories, which is also commonly known as Jai Stamp or Sarga Suli, was constructed by Maharaja Sawai Ishwari Singh. The most predominant temple of Govindevji was the first temple constructed in the city, which is the abode of more than 4,000 temples. Jaipur's rulers were devout Hindus who traced their descent from the sun god. The construction of these temples strictly follows the architectural styles mentioned in the Puranas. A rare painting of the Moti Dungri Palace. It was originally a small fort called Shankargarh, which was later renovated by Maharaja Sawai Man Singh II. A view of Moti Dungri and the Lakshmi Narayan Temple illuminated in the night leaves a mark on every passerby. night view of the Amir Fort seems almost precariously perched on the edge of the Aravali Hills, overlooking the pink city of Jaipur. This ancient statue of Shila Mata or Durga in her Kali avatar at Amir Fort was brought and installed here by Raja Man Singh I. The entrance door to the temple carries various incarnations of Goddess Durga. Jaigarh Fort's prized possession, Jaivan, which is the world's largest cannon on wheels. The Gaitor Ki Chhatriya is a complex of temples and tombs, which is a royal crematorium site. An aerial view of the Man Sagar Lake, taken by ace photographer K.K. Agarwal, with Jal Mahal or Water Palace in its center and hills in the background. In 1589, Raja Man Singh I constructed the Man Sagar Lake. Being one of the India's biggest man-made lakes, it was cleaned and made fit for bathing by the royal family after the Yagya. Man Sagar Lake area was developed by Jal Mahal's resorts of Kotharis. Experts were recruited from in and around the world to restore and revive its former glory. After renovation, in all the sophistication of 21st century lighting, Jal Mahal's Chameli Bagh is an oasis of tranquility. Galtaji, an ancient pilgrim site, was one of the prime sets of the Ramanan sect of Vaishnavites. Here is the Galta Gate, which derives its name from the renowned Galtaji temple of the Sun God. Noteworthy are the dual contrasting views of the city behind the gate. Built in the memory of Savai Madho Singh I, Sisodia Garden stands opposite the temple of Lord Vishnu. The view of the inner courtyard of the glorious Rambagh Palace Hotel. Central Park, popular site for morning walkers. A brand new version of the Stonehenge of Britain can be seen here as the new Stonehenge. The Rajasthan Legislative Assembly is a welcome addition to the rich heritage of the state and inspires its constituent legislators to be ever conscious of the needs and aspirations of the people. An illuminated night view of the Amar Jawan Jyoti or the Martyrs Memorial. A view of the artistic statue circle of Maharaja Sabai Jai Singh II during the twilight. A 100-year-old Panch Batti crossing, which is so called due to its 5 lights in the center. A perfect blend. sisters of Afghanistan. A riot of colors and designs are striking to the eye in these bundles of neatly rolled Jaipuri quilts. Blue pottery is the special art of Jaipur, which is popular worldwide. Deploying all natural and herbal dyes and pigments, this Persian style of ceramics is mainly embellished with motifs of natural flora and fauna in Rajasthan. Craftsmen are always experimenting with newer shapes and sizes for their creations so that they can be used for a variety of purposes. Ivory carving flourished in Jaipur under royal patronage and was very popular because objects were considered to be extremely auspicious. The silver mint or Chandi ki Taksal was also one of the 36 epochal karkhanas. Among the exceptional products of the State Department were two gigantic silver urns made of sterling silver, which the Guinness Book of World Records has listed as the largest silver objects in the world. In the craft of gems and jewelry, the city has the unique distinction of being one of the most important landmarks and a leading entity. Today, Jaipur is considered the gem and jewelry capital of the world. Of the 40,000 gem cutters and craftsmen of jewelry living today in the city, skilled craftsmen use diamonds, lacquer, gold and precious stones to create the famous Meenakari or enameled jewelry of Jaipur. J.C. Trunick, an internationally renowned jewelry expert, said, "I do not think there is any buyer in the world who is not aware of Jaipur jewelry and its reputation of consistent quality, which is like a Rolls-Royce among the jewelry of the world." Rajasthani paintings, especially the Jaipur style of paintings, termed as the Dhundar school of art, have become world famous with time. Initially, this art was made popular by Sahib Ram, Lal Chand, Lala and Muhammad Shah. Later on, this special form was adopted by the Jangir and Kumawat artists. Of the 36 karkhanas established by the king, the painting atelier was known as the Surat Khana and employed over 100 artists, artisans and calligraphists. Maharaja Sawai Pratap Singh was himself an artist and poet. He composed poems under the pen name of Brajnidhi. Some of the prominent artists during the rule of Maharaja Sawai Ram Singh II were Mangal and Chandar Jangir of Aligarh. Their successors, Muralidhar, Mohanlal and Mahipal, also took forward this tradition. In the 20th century, the world-famous artist Vedpal Sharma Bannu not only mastered the Jaipur style art form but also became famous in restoration of the miniature paintings. In the last century, Ganga Baksh, Haluka, Shiv Narayan Chogan, Master Jagannath, Subhagmal Gehlot, Ram Gopal Vijayvargiya, Kripal Singh Shekhawat, Devki Nandan Sharma and Dwarka Prasad Sharma made commendable contributions in popularizing both the art forms, which is proof of a very bright future of Rajasthan paintings in the world. The USP of Jaipur is the delicate balance between modern structures and its age-old heritage buildings. It was the holistic vision of the erstwhile rulers that set the city on the path to the modern era. After Rajasthan came under democratic rule, the city merged into the national mainstream and marched steadfastly forward. It is one of the few cities in the world that has a heritage management plan in place. The city has around 1200 heritage structures, of which more than 90% are within the walled city, and the aim is to maintain their historic status. Truly inspired and suitably enthralled by the glorious era of the Maharajas, the enterprising people of Jaipur themselves have played a pivotal role in the city's development. In this direction, present Chief Minister Srimati Vasundhara Raje has done commendable work for beautification and restoration of monuments of Jaipur. Her vision for Rajasthan is a prosperous, happy and self-reliant state where each citizen is educated and lives a life of dignity. On her initiative, the government of Rajasthan has finalized a plan for renovation and restoration of ancient monuments. Government agencies carried out extensive conservation, development and beautification works in the Amir Palace complex. The authority opened the tunnel from Amir to Jaigarh Fort. If the monuments and buildings of Jaipur speak of its glorious past, the fairs, festivals and cultural activities speak volumes of its rich cultural heritage. Celebrities cannot resist praising the splendor of its architecture and magnificent palaces. Jaipur has immense potential to emerge as key economic hub in North India. According to the World Bank study, this city has been ranked third in the country in terms of ease and speed of starting a business. Jaipur's national and multinational companies export to more than 100 countries. World's largest organization for handicaps, Jaipur Foot, is also located here. The city is fast becoming a hub for education, health and IT. Jaipur, as a brand, needs no introduction. Besides being a great tourist destination, Jaipur is also represented today by its ethnic products like gems and jewelry, textiles, handicrafts, miniature paintings, dolls and puppets, among others. These products, which are exported all over the world, have built an enduring brand image for the Pink City. A perfume brand, Jaipur, was also launched by the House of Boucheron in 1994. Several hotels and restaurants around the world have borrowed the name Jaipur to sell themselves. Amongst rare and beautiful stamps, several countries which have taken the theme Jaipur and honored the city. Today, the Pink City is regarded as a pristine jewel in the desert of Rajasthan, which is creating new global milestones. It is an eclectic mix of traditional values and modernism. Jaipur, as a brand, has been able to build a very strong equity for itself. The rare blend of antiquity and modernity is Jaipur's hallmark asset.